Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Civil Engineering Academy. My name's Cody. Let's go ahead and get started. So today we have a soil mechanics problem. In particular, this is a soil consolidation problem. And it says, a sample of sand has an initial relative density of 39% and a void ratio of 0.77. If the sand is compacted to a relative density of 65% and has a void ratio of 0.63, what is the decrease in thickness of a layer 4.5 feet thick? All right, so this one can be tricky. You got to kind of think outside the box, and that's exactly what we're going to do. We see the four options there in feet, so we know that, you know, we're not really going to have to convert really anything. So we need to use what we're given. And the trick to this is to find what formulas work for us. So you're going to have to control F to find a formula that fits what we're given. And in this particular instance, we can use a volume ratio. So if you remember, density is a function of volume. So those two correlate with one another. So here's kind of the ratio to get ahead of ourselves here. The ratio that we're going to be doing is the change in volume over your volume initial is equal to your volume initial minus your volume final over your volume initial. I get it. Okay, it's kind of confusing starting out, but we'll get a hold of it here in a minute. So our volume initial is going to be our volume when we're at 39% relative density. Our volume final is going to be when we're at 65% relative density. Okay, so we're going to be using these formulas. So our P in the PE, you're going to be looking at page 140. Look on that page. And in FE, we're going to be looking in 259. So I'm about to show you two different equations and how you can manipulate them to be the same exact thing. So for the PE, it gives us, I'll go ahead and label it here, for the PE, it gives us volume is equal to the volume of the solids times 1 plus your void ratio. The FE, however, gives you something a little different. You're going to have to solve for it. So it gives you your volume of the voids over your total volume is equal to, that's a V, is equal to your void ratio over 1 plus your void ratio. And so we can use that to solve for V. So in that case, V is equal to your volume of your voids times 1 plus E, all of that over E. Okay, and something to think about here, volume of your solids is going to be equal to the volume of your voids over E. So you can see how this turns out to be the exact same thing. You plug in your volume of your solids for VV over E, and you notice that, you know, you get the same exact thing that the PE says. So all that to say, we can use this equation to find what we need here. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to scroll down here and remember what we came up with. Delta V over VI, let's plug it in, volume of our solids times 1 plus E39 minus volume of your solids times 1 plus E65, and all that is over VS times 1 plus E39. All right, and so now you can kind of see the correlation here. We have our, this is our V39. This is our V65. And this is our V39. And remember, our V39 is our initial, V65 is our final. So, you can kind of see how, you know, this kind of works out. Volume of your solids cancels out, and we end up with something like this. Let me scroll down here. We end up with something like 1 plus 0.77 minus 1 plus 0.63 over 1 plus 0.77. And that ends up being 0.079. So this is our volume ratio. Remember, this is delta V over your V initial. We're going to find our change in height. Our delta height is equal to 4.5 feet times this ratio, 0.079. And you end up with 0.356 feet, and that looks like 0.36 feet. So that is your change in your height, and that's going to be B. And again, the way that we knew how to use this equation, right? The reason why we knew to use this relationship is because it gave us a lot of hints in the problem. It gave us a relative density. It gave us a void ratio. Hope this video helps, and we'll catch you next time.